Since talking about Bleach's supposedly possible midnight time slot for the Thousand Year Blood War arc, I thought it would be an interesting discussion talking about what really to expect if such a time slot were to occur. Now obviously no one expects the Blood War arc to be censored, it's quite literally within the name of what we can expect to come, and taking that aspect away from the arc would take away any impact from the story it's trying to present itself to be. As it pains me to say, we wouldn't want censorship like Terra from Mars for example, where, though removed from the Blu-ray editions, the TV version was, to be politely, unwatchable. The majority of the show was either blacked out or straight up nauseating. And we wouldn't want something like The Seven Deadly Sins either, where the impact of white glowy blood was shown too. Even worse, not to be rectified within its home release. Naturally, there is more, but these are the popular extremes. But after researching Bleach's past time slots and looking at the anime censorship, not only do I want to talk about why some parts take away from the magic of the series, but maybe give context why a midnight time slot is valuable to have. So, stick around. In terms of the entirety of Bleach, I think it would be a majority vote that the Soul Society arc is less notable, if or in fact for its censorship. Apart from the odd choice here and there such as Jidambo and Mayori's arm regeneration, the Soul Society had a Tuesday time slot and was hitting towards the end of primetime TV, kind of pushing what was considered acceptable for that slot. However, you will notice weird inconsistencies with the censorship in Bleach. Why is it 1 minute Ichigo and Renji are pouring blood like a fountain, and then the next Uryu and Renji is spitting out clear blood when Xyloporo is crushing every organ in their body? So, what's up with that? Truth be told, with the time slot changing back and forth and the Japanese laws repeatedly being amended, I struggle to find a concrete answer. Well, why is this, you say? Unlike the UK, where we have broadcasting guidelines, for example, with offensive words and imagery should not be really used before 9 p.m. and really after 5:30 a.m, the Japanese, as far as I can make out, have a right to self-regulate and govern themselves, seemingly dependent on the broadcaster. However, if the government deem contextual after 6 works in a year that they deem to be offensive, they can step in and enforce a self-regulation review. Then, if offences continue, they will be publicly shamed. This is just a ballpark idea, naturally. However, it does seem like they have an initiative of what's acceptable and what is not. For example, based on their age demographic of viewership. This is basing opinions from the Broadcast Act, or Act No. 132 of May 2nd, 1950, and Bill 156. With that being said, this bill was amended many different times throughout Bleach's run, and naturally animators and the broadcaster were finding their feet on what was okay and what was not. Hence why over time you saw Bleach start using black blood as a subsidiary. Unfortunately, Bleach around the Ironclaw arc moved to a different weekday and an earlier release of 6 p.m. rather than 7 p.m, causing Bleach to limit itself as TV Tokyo had a below 17s audience, which would turn some of Bleach's scenes questionable. Bleach would then go to keep its 6 p.m. time slot in the latter half, but popularity most likely suffered due to the inconsistent day switching and time slot changing. With the logistics out of the way though, I want to go over some shots and panels which I deem problematic to the series. And no, as much as I love Yoruichi's, Soifon's, Nell's and Haribel's side and underboob outfits, it really doesn't impact the story. I get it, it's a treat and a pleasant extra, however, nothing is affected besides you being horny. No horny. Horny bad. Rather, I'll be discussing more of the majors rather than the minors, as I'm sure the community will forever find new pieces of censorship. Though, if these small details are just being noticed now, then clearly it wasn't big enough to warrant an instant complaint. For example, would Noritora gagging Orihime's mouth really affect the current situation of the story? No, of course not. While it does go to show the sadistic characteristic of Noritora and would be consistent with his psychology of treating women as lesser beings, it's not particularly a scene that would cause outrage amongst the viewers, and the alternative paints the same picture, and it's an easy fix for home release such as Blu-rays, though this wasn't common then as it is today in current media. However, in the same scene where Ichigo versus Tesla, a foe Ichigo would have had no issue with, being fatigued with his fight against Grimmjow takes away from the traumatic experience Orihime is viewing right in front of her. The anime dragged this somewhat torturing of Ichigo to make up for how quick this encounter is, and gives a sense of suspense for the audience screaming for someone to come help him. Some scenes of Tesla breaking Ichigo's leg and then later snapping his arm like a matchstick were placed with sound effects, which still gave the audience a sense of what was really going on. However, visually would have created a bigger impact. There are other minor examples like this, such as Xylopro eating one of his minions. Again, it is minor. I find it takes a little away from the theme of the arc, seeing as these beings are ones that you can't reason with, like in the Soul Society. There is a moral and mental structure that is completely different in comparison to that of human nature. Things like Iryu's arrow piercing Xylopro in the stomach rather than the neck is also not a major change. A strange change, but one that is not a significant impact to the overall narrative of intention. However, if there is a little gripe that I had in terms of themes in the beginning of Bleach was the anime censorship of the ghost girl. While there was no blood on the ghost in the anime, I feel the censorship takes away from the traumatic experience the deaf can live with until they move on. When ghosts go to the Soul Society, they look healthy. However, until they move on, they will look as they do as the moment that they died. And it's kind of symbolic to the nature of the premise itself. So let's talk about the more problematic censorships that I personally had. After Ichigo defeats one of the gatekeepers of the Soul Society, Jidombo, Jidombo lifts the gate as a part of his duty, only to be met with Gin Ichimaru, a 13 court guard squad captain. In the anime, Gin uses his sword Shinzo to attack Jidombo's arm from holding the gate. This leaves a cut on his arm, making it inactive. While in the manga, this attack completely severs his arm from his body. Why is this so important? Well, given the context of the situation, this was a milestone of attention for the audience to see how incredibly strong the captains were. This is what Ichigo would come to fight. It was supposed to give an impact of the severity and lethality to the position of these characters, followed up with how far Orihime had come using her healing ability. It really kind of waters down the training that these characters did and waters down the threat level of the opposers. This was really the only part in the Soul Society that really rubbed me the wrong way, and I guess that one scene too of Nanao getting crushed by Yamamoto's pure presence of eye contact. The fact Yamamoto's strength was so suffocating, seeing Nanao's body grasp for air and becoming nauseated and almost seemingly crushed from the inside out really gives you a retrospect on suspense. The anime again does a well version of this, however watered down, and made her dizzy instead of a more severe outcome, but that's just a personal pet peeve of mine. My biggest gripe, however, comes with the very beginning of the Aranka arc where Okiura and Yami first appear. You're dealing with a more animal mentality rather than a human one. Chad, who was considered strong and durable, increasing his strength throughout the Soul Society, was backhanded easily in the anime. The aftermath was gruesome, of course, and it definitely displayed how much damage was received from one blow. But when you compare it with the manga, it's almost like something different happened. Chad's arm was not only ripped from his shoulder, but also his elbow. So the difference in action of Yami had changed. While one does show pure strength, the other one shows an over-excessive domination. In simpler terms, it's like hitting a fly with a fly swatter, and then you have grabbing a fly and pulling off its wings and then stepping on it, for the sake of going overboard. Sure, they tell the same event, but how it's done gives a massive threat difference in comparison to our last story arc. I think where the most underlying issues are, though, is the Karakura Town War arc. First off, there's Matsumoto versus Ion. If you can really call that a battle. Ion gets summoned by Hattie Bell's Fractiones by the three of them sacrificing their arms, which again was censored. But anywho, Ion appears and the first thing this mad lad does is attack Rongiku, which in the anime gives her a little bruise, and she's out of commission for a large portion of the battle. It's said that she could die if medical attention isn't given. While we as the viewer can't see this damage, it isn't until you read the manga that you start to see, I can see why that's a problem. Literally, almost half of her body was torn from her, intestines out and everything. It really puts into perspective why she wasn't in the fight for the majority of the war, and why Izuru struggled to heal her, and why he needed so much time. Censorships for this would be understandable, but they failed to explain and show any type of alternative middle ground to show us how severe things were. But it doesn't end there. We finally get to the big three boys, Gin, Aizen and Tozen. Hiyori rushes in and gets penetrated by Gin's sword, which is fine, to some extent. However, As we have seen in Bleach time and time and time again, sword injuries like that are quite tame in terms of Soul Reapers. Sure, Hiyori is damaged and out of commission, but Shinji's reaction, begging for Unohana and Orihime, is a bit far-fetched considering the amount of Soul Reapers with the ability to use Kido to heal. It isn't again until you read the manga that you truly see why the frantic urgency. Hiyori had been sliced in half, and any kind of healing done by any of the characters around them would have been all for nothing. Thus, as a reader rather than watcher, you can feel Shinji's pain and anger, his desperation and drive, while in the anime you would think he was being a bit melodramatic. Of course, there were little things too that I felt were pointless yet understandable, like changing Ichigo's Buddhist swastika in the Fullbring arc and Melanie's complete body restoration in the Uranka arc. It still shows Orihime's capabilities and how far she's come in strength, but it goes to tell the narrative of the original source, regardless of manga or anime. Uryu's vision of his grandpa's head in his eye would have been a nice touch too in terms of drama, but I suppose the backstory was a good justification. I would have loved to have seen Grimmjow's fist inside of Loopy's chest, purely out of badass reasons, and because I don't think anyone really likes Loopy, but again, I understand it. There are many different types of censorship within Bleach, some being more damaging than most, admittedly, but it is fun to deep dive into these comparisons, because while we could still get it on the midnight time slot of Bleach, we do now live in an era where most of these do get corrections and even added scenes, and the censorships do get rectified within the home releases. A midnight time slot is great if it happens, but please bear in mind that there still will be limitations, just less than other time slots. So, what is your guys' favourite censorship, or not so favourite censorship? Tell me of course in the comment section down below. If you like this video, of course, give it a massive like, and of course, hit that subscribe. It really means a lot, and hit the bell, because, you know, I guess it might work, I don't know. With that being said, I'm going to catch you guys later. You guys, of course, have this fine day, been Hanson, and as always, people, peace out.